Hey guys, today there's a question that's come from one of the parents on this 30-day challenge that I have taken up on non-academic fun activities. After seeing the video, thanks for asking this question because it's an eye-opener to me as well. And so I couldn't come back instantly. I'm going to read out this question and I'm going to attempt answering it in 3 to 4 different segments. So this is going to be a bit lengthy. So if you really have some of the work, please come back to this a little bit later. So let me read the question. And before that, I'm going to say a huge thanks to one and all encouraging me on this journey, because the entire idea of sharing this kind of content is to help me and help others as well. You know, we can't step out today to help anybody else, but this is the least I could do from my side. So thanks for that encouragement by asking this question. So I'm going to read the question. Hello Ramya, I watched your video on the 30-day challenge. It was very interesting. Thanks for doing it. Could you please suggest any games or toys that a 9-year-old boy would find very engaging to play with? Thank you. So I'm going to be splitting the question under 4 categories. One, I get to see glaringly, is the age. 2, toys. 3, engaging the child. And 4, play. Okay, so why am I segregating this? Let's dive into the answers. And before we get to see the answers from what I have to share to this parent and each and every one of you, let me clarify, I don't come under any therapist or a professional perspective, but I'm a parent. And lots of exposure, experience, tripping and falling and learning, that is what I'm going to be sharing here right now. And from my own personal experience of my childhood as well, I'm going to be intertwining into this. So let's get going into the answers. So first thing is age. Age is a very interesting concept. It's something which I have never understood even today. Because as we adults itself, we would have heard somebody tell us, you know, can you respond your age? Can you get mature to your age or whatever? Now, what is age? Age, in my opinion, is only a number. A person's understanding and capability through experience is when age can really get amalgamated. Okay. So, coming to the point on age, one, I would like to categorize it into 2 categories. One is the intellectual understanding of anybody under a category of age, and the other one is developmental factor. So these 2 are primary things we need to consider. So how do these toy industries categorize, 0 to 6 months or 6 to 12 months, this toy can be played by this segment of children? Is probably they'll take about some 100 or 200 children, give the toys, assess who are able to play in that category. Now, let's get into another concept of 80-20%. So they'll go with the larger percentage of children who can play a particular toy, and they will stamp it under this age group children can play. So let's not go from age perspective, but let's understand the level of the child and introduce toys accordingly. So that is why age doesn't matter as far as toys are concerned. Even I can sit and play something like a push and pull toy at this age. I might get engaged today, okay, let's, just do today. I don't feel like doing work. Or I might land up, I'm not able to stand, or there's too much happening in the world out there. I want to calm myself. I can just put the tracks of the train of my child and then turn on the key, put the train on the track and let it go round and round, and I can just look at it and get calmed. So toys and age should not be related is my personal opinion. So coming to the question of age appropriate toys, then the other aspect is we need to see the physical capability of the child. So if you're going to introduce a ball, for example, how much are the joint and muscle strengthening of the child come into play? Now, why am I talking these kind of information? Is this question has come from a father under our special needs group. So A lot of people think, you know, only when a child is non-verbal or when the child has a issue standing or sitting or have sensory issues or ADD or ADHD is when we need to look into account or take into account this age as a development and the intelligent quotient. No, this holds good for all of us. Unfortunately, it is only in that segment it's more spoken about, and the rest of them think, you know, why this child is not playing? I've bought so many toys. So it's not that way. It holds this categorization holds good for all of us. So that is something we need to reconsider. Now, why am I so talking about age is, a lot of people think age-appropriate toys have to be given. No, it has to be level-appropriate toys for the child. Let the market name that, you know, 9 to 6 months it can be introduced and all those things. Let that be. So who can identify what level the child is? You. It's only you. Primary person who can identify that are people next to the child, mostly the parent. So we need to understand at what level the child is and then get into understanding what kind of toys. Now, coming to the question of toys, which is the second aspect of my video here, is toys. Again, I want to split it under two categories. One, I want to talk about toys when we were kids and toys now. And the science behind these toys in the market. So let me put it as three categories. So one, let's always what I talk about is let's close our eyes is what I normally tell when I talk to parents. Let's close our eyes and imagine our childhood. How many toys did we have? Did we play? Did we have the time to play? We had time to play. Why do we feel there is no sufficient time? There are so many toys available in the market, but we think the child is not getting engaged into it. So my always, not just for toys, this holds good for anything. This is, you know, if anybody else is going to ask me any other question under any other category, my first question will be, can you close your eyes and think about your childhood? So this will be a standard question from my end. So think about our own childhood. What did we enjoy? How many toys did we have? It's easy for somebody to say, oh, then there was no great toys in the market and all those things. But if we think about the traditional toys, from where I come from in South, you know, we call this the Marapachi. Normally, it's not just kept in Navaratri or in the Golu, but it's also given to children to play. There'll be a one wooden toy of a man or a woman, and that's the only two toys children will hold, and they run around, jump around, climb up the trees. So there was more of external or with nature blending games. Today we are unable to do it in cities because, one, we don't have trees. Reason why we know why we are running behind oxygen today. So the other thing is this climbing up and down, our different shoulder strengthening exercises, finger strengthening exercises, which was naturally done. So today we are taking them to gym or many other things to say joint sensory and other things. This is my perception. So let's, if we have the child exploring outside as well, is half as good as play only. Okay. So before we continue to the toys, which toy will be applicable for this child? Coming back to the wood that I was talking about, there was a science behind the wood also in making toys traditionally. So that wood, when you're holding, when it's there around you, is supposed to be medicinal also. Now, I don't know the name of the tree, but I was told it has medicinal values. So that is one aspect. The other kind of toys, if you see, it's called chopusama. If I have to explain that, they are miniature versions of daily living. That is what was given as toys. Of course, other than, you know, bat and ball, which was cricket driven, or a hockey bat and a ball, or a tennis bat and a ball, those are different. That will be a little more for children above 5 years or 10 years to start playing with. Of course, while the age here given is 9 years, we will talk about that as well. So irrespective whether it's 10 years or 11 years, till the child hits a teen, not necessarily it was given only to girls, you know, to play chopusama or something, the miniature versions. What we understand from these kind of toys initially that was given are indirect playway method of what we normally do on a daily basis. So there would be a toy which has a comb, So, you know, the children know how to comb their own hair and all those things. So, those were the traditional approach of, or rather when we were children, how toys as such was introduced. There was nothing more, a greater structure of toys. There were some more toys in the market, yes. But not as many and overwhelming as today. That is where the confusion comes. Which toy should I introduce to my child? So coming to this generation of the toy industry, the moment there is a launch of any animated movie, there is a toy in the market. The moment there is, is also overwhelming for people, could be, but there is a science behind it, which I happened to read a few years ago. You can also Google up the research that was published, that this generation, we as adults, when we were children, we had this notion that there has to be toys. Okay, or somebody had a pen pencil in school. I couldn't get a pen pencil, so I'm going to be buying truckloads of pen pencils to my children even before they ask. I was craving for a cricket ball. You know, those days, you know, the entire street, 20 paisa per child will bring. Five children, five boys together will go to the tennis court, get one used up tennis rubber tennis ball for 1 rupee. And everybody will take turns to hold that ball for the entire day. So, I don't want my child to go through what I went through. This is common for all parenting strategies. So what we are doing today, the science is proving, is we as children have had this idea that somebody else had a toy, I was deprived of one. And today we kind of stack up toys. So coming to the question of toys and market, maybe that is also another reason why, you know, so many toys are coming up. I'll give you an example as to what I'm trying to say. There was this movie Frozen is so, the Lego and Frozen, these kind of movies are so very famous in the recent past. And if you see the market, there'll be one full shop of Lego toys. There'll be a shop half filled with Frozen princesses. Do you think a 3-year-old or a 5-year-old or a 10-year-old is so exhausted and interested in that movie and they want that toy? Actually speaking, no. Frozen is more of an adult movie, I would like to call it, because it talks about the Panchabhuta or the five elements and stuff, which is more adult intellectual aspect of it. So we wanted to be a princess when we were children, and so I take my daughter and say, come on, I'll get you a princess based gown, a toy. The child doesn't know. Oh, yeah, that's what it is. Where are they getting the idea from? It's from us. We get excited, and so they also equally get excited, and with peers. Now the peer pressure also adds on. So Lego is another aspect. Yes, building blocks and all is there. But should it have to be only Lego? That's a different question mark. So they are creating an idea that yes, kids need to be engaged as well. But constructive engagement is another aspect. So from toys, I'm going to come to engaging in the question. So toys, I leave it at that, saying different types of toys are available today, and today being an era where there are a lot of special needs category, we just can't have just one single toy. We have to keep exploring different things, and we are in a fortunate level where some children who have sensory needs, we need some toys and all those things, but not necessarily you have to have everything as toy based. It can be from anything that is in your environment, which is more natural and easy to understand, because tomorrow we want the child not to live in a fantasy world, but in a real world. That is my practical tip here as far as toys are concerned. And which is the most important toy for a child? I'm pausing here. I'm going to repeat the question. Which is the most important toy for any human child? If you have an answer, please mention in the comments below, because before I answer, I would really want you to pause and type out what you thought, because that's going to help me a lot in my understanding as to why I made this video. Here comes my answer. The most important and biggest toy is you. You, the father. You, the mother. You, the caregiver in the house. The caregiver can be anybody. The father, mother, brother, sister, grandparents, whoever it is. And primarily, it will be the mother and the father. For very many years, one can say, oh, only up to toddler, the children will be, no. Till they hit their teenage, the father is the godfather for any boy or a girl. So coming back to the question of toy, why did I say you is they like our engagement with them. The moment you come from office, the moment you come from even from a local market, you know, they are more happy to see you. They're not interested about the toy that they are holding. It's more interest about telling you what they did today with the toy. You are the most important person. So coming to the question of toys and you being the toy is also a relation to the next point of engaging that I'm going to come up with. They are going to be more interested in you. You are the godfather or the godmother for the child. So if you're going to be having the phone in your hand, the child will want a phone. So what kind of toy should I have to buy for the child? It has to be a phone. I repeat, if you're going to sit maximum number of hours in front of child on a laptop, buy a toy laptop for a child which can have educational apps in it. Making clear? If you're a person who spends time in the kitchen and the child is, we think the child is not looking at us, they are constantly observing us, they are much more intelligent than us, irrespective of coming under the category of special needs or otherwise. So they are observing us. So if you're in the kitchen and they have that smell, for identify which smell they love the most, whether it is garlic or onion or, you know, the seasoning that we put or the salt when they can come up or the whatever it is. Some, each children have, each of us have a taste preference and smell preference. So do children. So when they are coming to the kitchen for something in particular, are they seeing you use a knife? Are they seeing you tossing a vegetable? Give them one kadai, give them one, all the balanced peels of the onions and say, come on, you also do this, fry this in the corner. They'll be more than happy to play that way than the toys. So give miniature toys to them. So what kind of toys initially should we invest in? It doesn't need to be only at a toddler stage. It can be in any time. Only when they're going to cross adolescence, the way we need to look at things are going to be slightly different, because there's going to be my friend did that and father comes next. Always remember, we went through the same phase. We as a child, father was everything, mother was everything, and when we came to teenage, friends became everybody else. So till such time, considering the child is, even by biological, we call this the biological age, 9 years that he has mentioned, he's not come to the teenage category. So you need to see what you do. So are you exploring, do you do a lot of cleaning work in the house? Then buy them also a miniature mop and say, come on, let's do pretend play. I do the mop with this, you do a mopping here. So those are the kind of toys initially they're going to be interested in. Why? You are the most important person. Coming to the next thing on engaging. Particularly coming from a special needs category, they will find it difficult and challenging to engage themselves on their own. I repeat, they might find it difficult to engage in a play on their own. So engaging and play are the next two categories. So I'm going to come to engaging. If the child has to show that interest and get engaged into it, they have to see that happening in front of them. They have to hear that happening in front of them. When can that happen? Comes to the toy, the first toy that I was talking about, which is you. You will have to do that in front of the child. So whichever toy here we are going to buy, for example, let's say we have bought building blocks. You sit and do the building blocks in front of the child. Best will be, considering it's a 9-year-old, take the child along with you to the toy shop. Just go to the toy shop. Yes, now it's a lockdown. Now is a lockdown. When the lockdown lifts up, go to the store with the child. Let him take something in his hand. Don't bother about the rate of the product. Or rather, let me say, don't go to a shop which has too expensive stuff, okay, which goes to 1500, 2500. They might just take it for sensory need and they might not even play later. Go to a regular fancy store kind of a place where, you know, toys are generally hung around the place. Let the child just touch something and pick. You play the toy after coming home and they should come to you saying, no, that is something I picked it up. because the child should relate, particularly if it's a non-verbal child, this is very, very important. You have to go with the child because the child has to visually understand and see, this is something I have also bought, I should also play with this. How is he playing? Let me understand. How is he doing? Let me understand. And then engage into the play. So initially you have to play along first, and then the child will join you, and then later comes engaging the child on their own by keeping few toys there. You need to start playing with the child first and then pause and say, I have some work to do, I'm going to be doing my work, can you play, I'll join you in some time. But last 30 seconds, join the child and close it out by putting things back in its place. Now this is a better way of engaging, particularly for children who needs that kind of an extra support where they cannot, where it can be very overwhelming. So create one corner where it, you know, where you don't have anything else. The other segments of the house can be cluttered, it doesn't matter. That space alone, keep yourself and that toy alone so that there is no confusion for the child as to how to play it. And when they are exploring, let them explore in their own way. That is when engagement happens. Special needs category, even if 30 to 40 seconds the child is able to engage in the initial time, it's a big win. Let's not get into this subconscious. I have seen a great deal of parents who, you know, he can't even sit for 10 minutes. No, why should a child sit for 10 minutes under 10 years? That's when I say, go back, ask yourself, if you can't remember your own childhood, ask people around you, like your father, mother, your grandparents, or your aunt and whoever, uncles who have seen you in your child. They'll tell you, we were a brat. We were probably out on the road running. Today we can't send them out on the road running because there's too much of traffic, and the other important thing now being COVID. So play. Play is another interesting topic, you know. This is something even I have never understood, you know. A lot of people say playway method of teaching, playway method of teaching. Because under special needs category, the child is already introduced with toys physically and functionally to work with. When they see the similar set of toys at home, it is kind of overwhelming for them. They think it is therapy. This particular category I'm talking about is purely from special needs category, where children go for therapy, and a therapist would have tools in hand, which is primarily toys, you know. It'll be puzzles, because they want to introduce the word. If it's word engagement, they might have puzzles saying, this is father standing here, mother standing there, you are going here. So when they're going to see similar toys at home, they are going to think it is therapy. And that could be a reason why they do not want to get engaged with the same set of toys. What should we do here is identify what kind of toys that is already being used for therapy. Avoid those set at home unless and until the child goes and physically touches it and tries to tell you something about it. If particularly for places, you know, where therapists, they close the door, they make the parents sit outside. So we kind of don't know what tools they used. Talk to those therapists and figure out what those tools are. Just to understand so that you don't buy the same set, but similar way of doing something different. Because after all, at the end of the day, we're all going to be eating, bathing, wearing clothes. So toys can be something else for pretend play to, you know, put the shirt on for, if they are using let's say Barbie, use some other local toy. We have to change the kind look feel factor of the toy. So that's what I have to say as far as play and engaging is concerned. This is a big question mark. We tend to buy a lot of toys, but finally the child doesn't show interest. Why? Because the question which I would like to say is, could you please suggest any games or toys that a 9-year-old boy would find very engaging? Engaging again, engaging to play with, engaging to play with has to be with us and the toy, with us and the toy as an adult. And engaging can happen only when they are going to show interest. So let's alternate day, introduce something different. And that is when we can figure out what they are interested in. Some children will not be interested in you know, balls, to play with balls and all those things. But generally, it is an idea that boys will like to play with a lot of balls, cricket ball, bat. And when people come very lovingly to buy stuff for our children, they will end up buying age-appropriate stuff for us. Keep that aside. Use it in the future. Don't need to, you know, take it out. Oh, they bought this. We are unable to handle. These are few things, special needs parents, we all go through. So that is another thing that I was wanting to talk about as far as play is concerned. I know my face got a little serious. I'm sorry about that. But as I said, this is being a little, not just a little lengthy, quite lengthy. So thanks to this father who asked this question, I hope I have in some way been sharing my experiences and understanding as to how I look at play. It's very easy to say, you know, playway method of teaching when the child doesn't engage. How to engage? We have to try and turn every stone as we go and upturn every route to see which method works fine. It's okay if it takes time, but we can do it and it will happen. And the most important thing is all kids do this today. All kids. They work with one thing today, show interest, next day it goes to the corner. So what is another important thing as far as play and toys are concerned is you have to have one separate big box to keep all the toys played today goes in there. Keep it just outside for a week, 10 days. They might pull out and then try playing again. Just put it back inside and rotate the toys after some time. All kids today do that. All of us do that. You know, see, that's where I keep saying we have to understand us also in this. We are the first set of people that those children see. When watching a video, we just scroll, tuck, tuck, tuck. What next? What next? Oh, this is boring. What next? So in all probability, you haven't even reached to this phase of my video, but you've already scrolled to see, is there anybody else saying anything else? So children also would like to do that, you know, they get bored with one toy. What next? So keep a few toys which they have already seen. Repetition is very important as far as special needs children are concerned. But if you are going to say, come, let's play this, they are not going to get engaged. First, they have to get engaged with us and the toys. And then they should find, yes, it's fun. I can do it attitude is a very important thing for everybody. Particularly under special needs, when the child is already aware, I'm not able to talk like you. I'm not able to communicate like you. I'm not able to play like you. The moment we look at somebody as adults, let's forget the child here, as adults, when we look at somebody who's wearing a better clothing than us or a better hairstyle in our standards than us, you know, immediately there's one small thing, we turn our eyes away. Or if somebody is asking a question, we don't know to answer that, you know, we look in directions. We don't give that eye contact. When, you know, somebody is in a very amazing command of language, I shy away. Do you? So those are similar things that are happening to this child as well. So confidence is very important. Even if they do the most unexpected thing, but for them it's a big win. Encourage them. They don't need reinforcer like chocolate and all those things. All they will need is a good hug and kiss or a clap saying, wow, you did this. And that's it. That for the day, that toy is enough. We can always redo it a little later. But so have a big bin or whatever to keep all, stacking up all the different kind of toys which you want to keep rotating. And the most important thing is children like what you do. So if you're constantly on the phone or a laptop, they are going to be asking only that. That is going to be the toy they're going to enjoy most. And more primarily, I have seen this, I'm going to explain from my experience. I happen to see one of a very old video where my little one, when he was about hardly 1.5 years, not even 1.5 years, he's keeping the phone, his first toy phone which his uncle had got from Dubai. It actually has keys which will also give music, but he does king king king, puts it in between his ears like this, okay, and walking around the house, oh no, it's basically blabbering age, that is. And when I saw the video, I was amazed. He's been pretend playing exactly with stress, pause, walking, keeping the hand like this, everything just like his father. And so I'm going to sign off with that note saying, children observe us and they're going to do only what we are doing. So you are the most important person as far as play or toys are concerned to keep them engaged. You have to give that amount of time with the child and automatically they will start showing interest in any toy. And considering specific question asked about what kind of games or toys, I would suggest try everything that is there in the world, and whatever toys that I'm trying since this parent has asked, I will definitely do a video on that. Do give some time and I will keep posting it. Thank you. Bye-bye. Have a fantastic time.